And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3 Blind. I am the RPG chick. Let's talk to Primarch Victus.
Commander.
You said one of your ships had gone missing.
Mm-hmm.
Crashed, actually. I couldn't speak in front of the Krogan. Our ship went down on Tuchanka. Now they're pinned by an advanced guard of Reapers scouting the planet.
What are your men doing there?
I'm sorry. That's classified.
Huh, well, you want my help, don't
but
you?
It's vital they be rescued. They must complete their original mission. It's a matter of galactic peace.
Hmm.
I'll do what I can.
I appreciate your help and understanding.
About this ship.
Your men that crashed onto Tuchanka, how many are there?
A platoon.
You said their mission was a matter of galactic peace. Why?
I'm sorry, Commander. As I said, it's highly classified.
Hmm.
Look, if you want me to put my ass on the line, I need answers.
Get him.
I can't tell you. Please understand.
We have to find out.
The Commander is Lieutenant Tarquin Victus. He'll be your contact.
Tarquin?
Victus?
My son. I needed someone I could trust completely.
Oh, your son. I know the name Tarquin from somewhere, too. Tarquin.
How is it being the Primarch?
Not what I imagined. The battle of all time is happening on Palavin, and I'm light years away. Reading casualty reports in the millions.
Hmm.
If I'm going to die, I want to be with my men, so there's no doubt we fought to the last soul.
I don't remember him saying all that, but it doesn't stand out either, if that means anything. I can relate to that.
I understand. Leaving Earth to save it, it's one of the hardest things I've ever done.
I'm not surprised. Garrus speaks highly of you.
I think
you
this
never
is new.
Asked to be a leader, yet your people will die if you refuse. We find ourselves in similar circumstances. Let's hope the spirits grant us the strength to see it through.
Okay. Turian help for Earth.
I understand this is a difficult time for you, Primarch, but Earth can't survive without reinforcements. Can I still count on your help?
If the Krogan help us on Palavin, then I give you my word.
Hmm. Situation on Palavin, by the way.
How are things on Palavin?
The casualty reports are staggering. The Reapers are using our own tactics against us. Destroy the enemy with overwhelming force.
I've seen the same on Earth.
The strategist in me admires their brutality. The Turian in me knows I'm watching the destruction of 15,000 years of civilization.
This I remember.
My civilization.
The Krogan will help you.
The Krogan will make sure that doesn't happen.
Assuming you're successful with the cure.
This is new,
though. We
will
be.
You have to be, Commander. I don't want to go down as history's last Primarch.
I just said we will be. After the genophage cure...
The Solarian Dalatras worries about what the Krogan will do once they're cured. How do you feel?
It won't matter if we don't stop the Reapers, but I understand her doubts. The moon you found me on? That's where we made our last stand against the Krogan during the rebellions. They were that relentless.
Your last stand?
How did it turn out?
The Krogan started using asteroids as weapons, directing them against our colonies.
All right, we
had
this.
No choice. The genophage was our last resort.
Basically, mass
so
drivers.
Yes, Krogan intentions after this war will be a serious concern, but I'd rather have a grateful ally than a resentful enemy.
Hmm. Well, Krogans make unusual allies.
Reaching out to the Krogan for help must be difficult for you.
We can't allow the mistakes of our past to cloud the future. Your race and mine were once enemies.
True.
The first contact war, as you call it. I was there, dodging shells fired by your navy.
Hmm.
But look at us now, standing in a ship of Turian human design, working together.
Yep. It's pretty awesome, I have to say. All right, well, that's it then.
That's all.
Of course, Commander.
Journal updated for Turian Platoon. Here's Wrex. So they're not very far away from each other. They want privacy from each other, but they're both going to sit here in the same room. Let's check out this. Well, okay, I got it up. Or down, rather. Primarch Victus reports that a Turian ship on a secret mission crashed onto Chanka. Land onto Chanka to rescue the platoon. Okay, our quests are, you know, adding up here. And we're about to gain another one, I'm sure.
Hell of a show down there on Sir Kesh. Just like the old days, Shepard.
That's right.
Right down to me pulling your ass out of the fire.
Hey now.
I was the one with bullets flying at me.
And I gave you the moral support to dodge them.
Nah.
Uh-huh. You said one of your squads is missing.
They were scouting out the Rachni relay. We've heard rumors of trouble in the area.
Rachni?
Thought that might get your attention. I have a favor to ask. It's big.
Don't tell me they're back.
All I know for sure is our scouts went silent as soon as they arrived.
They're supposed to be leaving the sector or something.
My best unit on standby. You give the word, and they'll meet you there.
I'll see what I can do.
Get on it, Shepard.
The Rachni, huh?
How could there be trouble with the Rachni? They were all but extinct. The last queen promised to disappear forever or be destroyed.
Right.
I know, I was there. I've got a bad feeling about this. It may not be Rachni. Maybe it is. Could be another invasion. If they're crawling out from under some rock, you know how bad it could get. We need to stop them.
Yep. And the Krogan have fought plenty of Rachni. That's for sure. So, for context, in the first Mass Effect, I spared the Queen, so, which is probably obvious to you guys. How's the female Krogan? I'm gonna ask something about the female Krogan.
Back on Sir Kesh, it looked like the female Krogan could hold her own.
Yeah.
Our females don't lack for spirit. For males, a good show of force sorts things out. But females like to talk about it, then think about it. Then talk about it some more. No offense.
Believe it or not, we sometimes have good ideas, Wrex. You should try listening.
That's right.
Yeah, but our women have so many of them. So sometimes I pretend to listen and... Well, let's just say Krogan females have tempers too.
I'm sure they do. T'Chanka.
What's the situation back on T'Chanka?
I'm still getting scattered reports of Reaper forces arriving. Something big is brewing. I won't let those things take T'Chanka. Not when we're about to cure the genophage. My people have had enough bad luck in our time.
I agree there. Definitely see where he's coming from. After the cure?
What will you do after the genophage is cured?
Once we deal with the Reapers, most Krogan will want to settle a score with the Turians and Salarians.
Not good.
I won't let them.
Good.
That isn't our path forward. This time will be different.
Glad to hear it.
A lot of people will be relieved to hear that. No one wants to repeat history.
They know we'd probably win this time. But war has never brought us anything except misery. It's time to focus on rebuilding.
That's a pretty un-Krogan sentiment. At least to me it seems so.
That's it for now, Wrex. Let's get back to work.
Anytime.
Anytime.
And Shepard, I like what you've done with the Normandy. Got tired of always hanging around the cargo bay before. I still don't have a window like Liara does, but Maybe that's because I don't kiss as well.
No comment.
I miss this place. Wish I could knock some heads around with you, but duty calls. If the Solarian says my DNA is important, who am I to argue?
I don't know how a Shepherd could be so serious. I'd be dying right now. Next quest. A Krogan scouting team has gone missing while investigating rumors of activity at the Rachni Relay. Investigate the missing team and find out what happened. Alright. Let's check in on the rest of the ship. Just checking for stuff to be added.
Do you think Solarians would have a base on their homeworld secured better?
They were solid. Cerberus has Reaper tech. Compared to those upgrades, the Solarians might as well have been throwing rocks.
Commander, we've got new reports of Cerberus activity on T'Chunka. I've marked it on the galaxy map.
Okay. Cerberus is taking control of an old military installation on T'Chunka for unknown reasons. Land on T'Chunka and neutralize whatever operations Cerberus has in the area. Kanok?
Commander, nice to see you again.
How are you settling in, Trainer?
I actually feel somewhat useful. Right. It's been challenging to integrate data feeds for the war summit.
How are the systems holding?
Well, I'm glad we performed stress tests.
Specialist training really? Has been extremely helpful. The accuracy of our war room data is a direct result of her work.
Glowing praise.
Thank you, Edie. I'm still getting used to all of this. In the lab, we hoard everything, piles of tech everywhere. Out here, it's like living out of a shoebox.
You'll be okay.
Life on an active ship always feels crowded at first. You'll get used to it.
Oh, it's not a bad thing. I've got no problems getting cozy. This is wonderful. Back in the lab, we had to hoard because we had no budget. Now, Edie, Ariaki Tech uses a proprietary smart processing algorithm that could clean up our long-range data. Can we license it?
We can. Analyzing and applying the upgrade now. The algorithm should reduce long-range strategic combat data analysis time by 3%.
Impressive.
If it means getting the equipment I need, I can quite happily live out of a shoebox.
Yeah, well, this shoebox kicks some major ass. Don't forget that. ANN alert. New article on indoctrination. From Alliance News Network. Well, that's what ANN is. Network Information Partners. Thessia. Asari scientist Rana Thanaptis. I remember her. Oh. She died. She died in custody, allegedly committing suicide after she was arrested for the murder of multiple Asari military officials. Yeah, we spared her in the first game, right? Prior, and then we ran into her in the second game, yeah, I remember. Prior to her death, investigators said Thanaptis spoke of voices in her head, which they believed to be indicative of her indoctrination. The voices foretold the ascension of the Asari and told Thanaptis that anyone fighting the Reapers, quote-unquote, needed to die. Thanaptis worked on a top-secret project for a former Spectre Saren Artarius several years ago, where she likely became indoctrinated. She received a pardon from the Asari government in exchange for providing research assistance on Reaper technology. Thanaptis was believed responsible for planting a makeshift explosive device that detonated at a research center, killing 5 visiting Asari military officials along with 4 civilians. The attack seriously wounded a dozen more and caused significant damage to the facility. Investigators say they are not seeking any more suspects in the case. Info for you, really. Hi, Shepard. Oh, Farron. It's been a while. I'm glad you made it off Earth and that Liara is with you. Getting off her old ship was the best thing we could have done. Can't tell you how sick I was of that cabin and of tripping over that drone. I don't even know how it kept finding me in a ship that big, even after I turned off its tracking. I dug up some interesting information for you. Talk with Glyph to sort out the data. I hope it helps, Shepard. It's getting rough out there. Farron. Alright, so I got stuff to check out in the terminal. In the Ara's quarters. Check in on Joker.
Krogan and the Turians really should get behind the Alliance. They've got so much in common, like shooting things and not wanting to die. And... no, that's about it.
That's about it. What's up, Joker?
So, bringing the Krogan to a war summit went well? You want me to invite the Batarians too? Or the Borcha?
We have to stand together.
Building alliances is the only way we stand a chance against the Reapers.
Yeah, but the Krogan? I'd feel better if we had a tighter plan, like time travel or teaching the Reapers to love. Still, good to have Morden back. The bad guys shouldn't get the monopoly on mad scientists.
That's so funny.
Commander?
It is good you came by. I have questions about the genophage.
You and everyone else.
I
what
know.
Do you need, Edie?
A Krogan female of breeding age can produce clutches of up to 1,000 fertilized eggs over the course of a year. There are over 1 billion females on T'Chanka. If even 1% become fully fertile, they can birth 10 billion infants.
On Earth, bugs have a lot of young, too. Most of them die.
The attrition rate would naturally be high, but the state has an interest in keeping the children alive for warfare purposes.
Any other cheerful thoughts?
Logistics. Even were they to side with us, transporting the Krogan to the battlefield of Palavin could prove difficult. They have been demilitarized. That is, they have no warships.
What do you suggest?
They will need Turian or civilian starships to carry them to battle. With your permission, I will make the necessary calls to have these ships in place for when you deliver the Krogan.
Damn. Anything else?
Food. They will be unable to eat anything on Palavin. They must bring their own or rely on the nutrients in their humps.
This keeps getting better and better.
The Krogan will also require sedatives, since Krogan fight with others of their kind in enclosed spaces such as starships.
Oh god.
Make it happen. Are there any last things you're worried about?
Nothing that demands your attention, Shepard.
Yeah, living beings, they require care just like everyone else, and sedatives.
Morden sent me a nicely crafted message. It seems he recalls our conversations about the Salarian equivalent of transhumans.
If I could, I'd stop you right there.
Uh-huh. Transhumans have some of their brain's abilities, such as memory, supplemented or entirely replaced by cybernetics. Legal definitions vary from planet to planet. The Salarians embrace the concept. Humans have diverse and contentious opinions.
Do my implants make me a transhuman?
That would be telling.
What?
Huh? I'm sorry. That was a joke. You are fully human. Cerberus extensively reconstructed you, but your brain functions are organic.
Don't ever do that again.
Yeah. Those jokes suck.
Hello, Shepard.
Anyway. Oh, right. I keep forgetting. Was that it? Was that her that said that? I thought it said Westmoreland or something.
Commander.
I guess it was the other one. Beyond the screen there. Shuttle bay. Don't let a brute get close. Oh right, we got some improvements to make. I forgot what we even picked up. Bunch. Spare shot capacity. Increases damage. Piercing mod. Enhanced scope. I'm gonna leave that alone. Increases accuracy. Damage. Piercing. Magazine upgrade. Keep that as well. Magazine upgrade. Weapon weight. Accuracy. Oh, because I left it like that. Oh, we got a mod here that... So I got high caliber barrel 1. Thermal clip 1. Or bladed... I'm going to use the thermal clip actually for that. Pistol piercing. Magazine upgrade 2. Is that increases accuracy or damage? I'll leave these the same. Alright, guys. Yeah. Negative 200%. I know, guys. I know. If it gets too hard that way, I will just change it. So, weapon upgrades. Right. I'm not even gonna mess with this stuff. I mean, I can. But I'm thinking that's going to be more of an off-screen thing, maybe? I do go through these, so I'm going to take... Managel Capacity 2. Can't afford that. And I'm leaving the others. Oh, the armor locker. Okay, because we found some armor. Breather helmet. I don't remember what we found. Shield regeneration and 7 for health boost. I'm pretty sure we had that one. This must be new. It's basically the same, only instead of shield, we got power damage. Weapon damage. Yeah. I'm gonna stick with the Saris Council on that. Shoulders. Keep that. Arms. See the difference. Melee damage. Keep it N7 for that. Weapon damage for the Hain Kadar. What else changes? Ammo capacity. Yeah, I'm gonna keep that for the ammo capacity. Alright. Welding stuff.
Everything okay with the shuttle?
Just double checking the inertia dampener coils. Can be twitchy in these UT-47s. But don't worry, this bird's been rock solid.
Do you ever rest?
I always see you down here working your ass off. Ever take any downtime?
I get my sleep, Commander. Flying tired is nearly worse than flying drunk.
What about your waking hours? Any R&R?
I need to keep myself busy. Otherwise, well, too much time to think.
Yeah, I know. Don't work too hard.
I appreciate your dedication, but I don't want to see you burn out.
I know my limits. I wouldn't take a chance with your life.
How about with your own?
So before this war, you must have done something to relax.
Sure. I remember back when the Hawking was based out of Arcturus and I was just a fighter jet. There was this observation deck overlooking the main flight paths. You could watch every ship taxi in and out. When I was alone, I'd turn off the auditory emulators and just watch them drift by in silence.
You know there are views like that on the Citadel. Next time we're there, you should take some shore leave. Clear your head.
I don't know. Maybe.
Yeah, we'll take this choice. Do it for me.
Take some time off on the Citadel, Steve. As a favor to me.
If you put it that way, how can I say no?
There you go.
You can't.
You can't.
Sir Kesh certainly offered me a new experience.
What do you mean?
Normally I'm not one to fly co-pilot, but when an 800-pound Krogan requests to take control of your shuttle, you comply.
Probably wise.
I hope I didn't leave you hanging too long on that last Cerberus raid.
No. Just glad we made it out in one piece.
Been a while since I've seen a dogfight like that. Really missed my Trident. ACM isn't really the Kodiak strong suit. Just one more diagnostic suite. Hello, Commander.
I can't go that way. Let's check in on James.
Wonder what the hell Cerberus was up to on Sir Kesh.
They want to use Reaper tech for their own ends.
I hear we're headed to T'Chunka. Would love to see how things turn out. I'm just saying.
Yep.
Wrex is a badass.
Yeah.
I bet he's got some real interesting stories to tell.
Yes, he does. I've heard plenty.
More than something else. His mouth moves faster than a frog on a hot rock in the middle of summer.
Well, there's a saying.
Ready when you are. Ready when you are.
What are we ready for? Alright, let's get out of here. I head to engineering. Yeah, right. Map. Yeah, right. Our friend, our engineer, isn't in engineering. He's in the crew quarters. So Allers is this way. You know, I just want to see. Yep. You deserve some downtime as well.
Hey, just an opinion piece. You don't like it? Don't download it.
You're saying we don't need Terra Nova.
What's going on here?
One colony, save five. That's the math.
You know what the commander did for us? The colony?
Yes.
The quotes.
It was on a little thing called the news.
You think you can fly on this ship, sit next to us at chow time, and then broadcast something like that? That's traitorous.
Hey, it's just an opinion piece. You don't like it? Don't download it.
You're saying we don't need Terra Nova.
Lose one colony, save five. That's the math.
You know what the commander did for us? The colony?
Yes.
Lose the piece or lose your spot on this ship, Allers.
This is exactly what I was afraid of.
I just want to talk to him, actually.
Doesn't matter. What's your choice, Allers? Like you said, it's just your opinion, right?
I'll pull it.
She coughs. I got plus two reputation, though.
Cerberus stealthily strikes Star System Shield. No, glad I read that one out loud.
Hmm. All the alliteration there.
Do we need to talk, Commander?
Nope.
Not right now, Allers.
Let me know when we do.
Okay. Is there a wall of photos? Called John Colson? Omega. Oh, that was interesting. I guess if I clicked her, I would have supported her. I really wanted just more information. But that's okay. Crew deck. Where everyone's hanging out right now.
I can't imagine anything so traumatic. You sure you're okay, Karen?
I wouldn't wish a collector abduction on my worst enemy. But it's behind me now. I'm fine. But it makes me think of Earth and all the other Reaper-occupied worlds. What are the Reapers doing to the people who live on all those worlds? As we sit here, enjoying our coffee. How many souls are in agony this very moment? Millions? Billions?
Yeah.
Oh, Greg. I lied. I'm not fine.
Aww.
Everything okay in the med bay?
Yes. Morden would just like some space to work with Eve.
He kicked you out?
Oh, no. I just felt I was getting in his way. I'll return when I'm needed.
Well, it's not what I wanted to ask her about.
Commander.
Hello, Commander. Hello, Commander.
Okay. Looks like we're done here. Hmm. Yeah, there's no one in there. Oh, we got Garrus, Liara, Morden, and the female Krogan.